Hi, hope you're all well. Matt from NTrack here. In this tutorial, we're going to look at how to adjust vocal levels using the volume envelope tool in NTrack Studio for iOS and Android. This can also be called vocal riding. It involves making the vocal part smoother through volume via fade-ins, fade-outs, and other volume automation. Let's get into it. So as you can see, we've got a vocal one and a vocal two part set up in this NTrack Studio iOS session. In the center of each part, you can see a green horizontal line. This is the volume envelope, which has already been selected like so in the bottom menu bar. To remove the volume envelope's view, just select another tool from the same menu. Let's go back to the volume envelope tool and explore more. So before we edit the first vocal part, let's hear it. We'll solo the vocal one part and press play. Although the vocal itself is great, one thing that strikes me is that the start is a little rough. Just that intro part there. You should hear it doesn't come in as smooth as it should. There it is again. So let's go ahead and tidy this part up. We'll click on the green horizontal line from part one, which will create a green circle called a node. We can then click and drag down on the first node to create a fade in. And you can hear that creating that long fade in creates a much smoother entry for the vocal. To remove a node, simply double tap on the node that you wish to lose. In this case, we've double tapped on the second node, which has taken the volume envelope right down to minus infinity, which is the volume position of the first node. So that's something to watch out for. To return the volume envelope back to its default position, we can simply double tap on the first node. So there's the less smooth original version. And let's add the second node back in and hear the difference with the fade in. Let's go on and re-listen to the rest of the part. This ending here has a slight click. There it is again, so it's not as smooth as it could be. So we'll add a fade out by adding two nodes and dragging the second one down. But as we can hear, this fade out is a bit exaggerated. So as you can see, we've shortened the length of the fade out to see how that sounds. It's still too pronounced, so let's shorten it again by clicking and dragging on the node we want to adjust. Let's hear that again. It's still too much, we only want to remove the click at the end, so let's move that mode much further forward. Ah, that's better, but it might be a touch too far forward. To my ears, that sounds much cleaner. Let's zoom in and go back to the start of the track to look at how to curve a volume envelope. When a node is selected, another one appears directly above. By tapping and holding this node and then dragging left or right, you can affect the angle of the envelope, which means intensity of the fades can be manipulated. Let's double click the first node to straighten the envelope. As we push and drag it down, we'll rotate the envelope the other way. If we want to return the angle of the envelope back to the original, again, click, hold and rotate the node above the one selected. Let's move on to the end of this part and go through how the same technique can be used on the fade out. We'll bring the node back to illustrate the example more. Again, by tapping, holding, and rotating the node above the one selected, we can change the angle of the envelope. Now, let's look at how we can use volume envelopes to make a small portion of the vocal louder than the rest of the part. Let's use this as the example. The intensity of the vocal part is higher here, so it's a good place to ride the vocal and use the volume envelopes to increase the volume. As ever, let's select some nodes by clicking where we want them on the green horizontal line. The second node from the left is where this particular phrase starts. Let's drag it up to increase the volume. And the second node from the right is where this section ends. So we'll do the same. Let's hear that again. We can clearly hear that that section has become louder through changing the position of the envelopes. Let's double click on the nodes to remove them and return the part volume back to the original. We're going to now move on to the second vocal example to look at how we can use volume enveloping to hide certain sections of the vocal, like background noise or unwanted parts. Let's take a listen.
I step out onto the stage, take a deep breath, the music starts to play, the lights are turned down, I hear the roar from the crowd.
Okay, so what if we didn't want this vocal effect at the end of the phrase? Let's use volume enveloping to make it inaudible. We'll select the volume envelope tool and add two nodes to the left of this particular section. And we'll need to zoom in a bit more to make this more exact. So let's add that second node and click and drag it down to mute the last section of this part. And let's click and drag the first node left some more to create a smoother fade. We can make that smoother still. Let's drag the second node further right. Let's also see how it sounds by curving the envelope. Better, but there's a click at the end. It's still there. That should be it. Much smoother, much better. Let's compare it with before. Against our last version. Okay, let's return to the start of the part.
I step out onto the stage.
I'm sure you can hear there's a lot of background noise just there. We can use the volume envelope tool to minimize this. So let's start by selecting a node and we'll place a second node to the right of that. Let's also place two nodes to where the audible background noise finishes. We'll take the inside nodes and drag them right down, muting the signal. Though to my ears at that angle, the mute's too sudden. So let's adjust the node. There's an improvement there, but it could still be better. Okay, now that's sounding more natural. Let's bring the first node back a little more. Okay, let's hear that again.
I step out onto the stage.
And let's double tap to remove the relevant nodes and hear the difference from before.
The stage.
And again with the envelope changed.
Onto the stage.
The final thing on enveloping that we wanted to mention is that panning can also be controlled in this way. As you can see here, panning is also controlled by nodes and dragging up or down.
Stage.
So we can hear the pan to the right by dragging down.
Stage.
And it pans to the left by dragging up. We return to the volume envelope by clicking on the envelope tool and selecting volume from the menu. Okay guys, as ever, we hope you enjoyed the video, learned some information about vocal riding. Please subscribe, like, share, and all the good stuff. Any questions, let us know. We've also put the links to download N-Track Studio on iOS, Android, Windows, and Mac in the YouTube description. See you on the next video, and in the meantime, have fun making music.